Hello viewers, you're welcome to Debreton Show, and my guest today is Petola. Petola is a software developer and he has been in business or an entrepreneur for 6 years now, and today he's here to talk to us more about what he does and how that can be beneficial to companies and also individuals who are interested in his service. Petola, you're welcome today to the show.
Thank you.
I'm happy
it's my
to see
pleasure.
You. Yeah. Thank you for coming here. So, I mean, it wasn't easy to get you here today, and I believe that you're a busy person, and today I appreciate you coming here today to talk about what you do.
It's an awesome opportunity. Yeah.
So please, can you tell our viewers, like, who is Petola? I mean, what do you do?
Hello, so I am Viljami Petola, and my profession is software, and I love building software, I love building things. So yeah. that's where usually my clients hire me.
Yeah, wow. So kind of like, what do you build? Are you building kind of like, what type of software do you build? Kind of like, you know?
Web software, websites, augmented reality on web platform or web systems. Not usually websites, I don't do WordPress stuff, but if some larger corporation, something custom, or maybe a startup, very, very specific that you cannot build with, for example, WordPress.
Okay, so I mean, is it kind of like, do you build robots? Kind of like, okay, software, do you build like kind of like software that is being used for robots? Or kind of, I don't know, is it kind of like robotic? Or
I could connect a robot, system of robots to share their sensor data and in a centralized storage, like database, and then analyze that data. Okay. I'm not the one building the robot. I could program simple robot like Arduino, microchips, and this kind of stuff. But more of the connection of things.
Okay. So, well, I mean, what are you doing? What project are you really up to right now?
That is actually like, because I have my own business.
Yeah.
I run my own business, and I recently moved back to Tampere. I've been half a year in Northern America doing climbing and software.
Okay.
And I did the same thing in UK, mostly software there.
Okay.
And I'm climbing and building products in Australia. So now I'm trying to do that in Finland and figuring out how Finnish market is.
Okay.
And how I built is that what I have now ongoing is in Finland is that I'm developing a game to my friend's platform, who has his own business in Finland.
Okay.
And I have there a game designer to walk me through of the actual story, how and why. Another thing is that I'm building a marketing boost platform with two other entrepreneurs. That's like a joint venture.
Okay.
And the third is augmented reality and VR, which I'm trying to promote and get a new perspectives how to make that as an maybe a branch of my business.
Okay.
But recent past big project were being part of a web developer team.
Okay.
Mentoring with front end technologies and bringing something what they didn't have in-house they bought from me.
So your customers are more companies, are mostly companies?
Definitely companies.
Okay.
It's a B2B market.
Yeah, B2B market. So, I mean, what really inspired you to be engaged in something like this? You know, I know Finland is kind of like a technology world, you know, kind of so many things happening when it comes to technology. But to you, what is that force that drives you to do what you do?
That is fascinating. I've found myself kind of drift to this place where I know I love software, I love coding. It's like playing a game.
Exactly.
Like I don't anymore play so much games. I might build something that is a game, but for me the playing part is the actual like writing, the creation of the software.
Okay.
And so I want to do more what I like.
Okay.
I generally. I'm also a social software engineer. You know the caricature you're just with your hiding somewhere.
So
that's not me. I like people.
Yeah.
I love conversation. I love social person as yourself. So it's It's more, it's a combination of finding the client need, what is actually needing to be built, and can software solve that? And if software can solve the client need or the company need, then we start building. And the building and the interaction with what is needed is the absolutely best part of pretty much what I do for my profession.
Yeah, that's really good, you know, that's powerful. Yeah. I mean, it's kind of like Colin really gives kind of like a focus, sense of focus of actually what you're doing. Because, you know, networking with people, trying to do something that will actually make you to relate with people and to try to see how it kind of like more of communicating, networking is powerful.
Exactly. Yeah. And then there comes the power that more people are like participant, how well they communicate. That also means how good the software is gonna be. Because there is a convoy's law which states that that software has limitations based on the communication limitations.
Yeah.
So it's better to be open and try to create an environment where people can like voice their issues or say what it works or and speak freely.
Yeah. Do you think this is what makes you different from, I mean,
that is definitely my strength.
Yeah.
And when I go abroad, another thing is that it's Finland is a big brand. It's like being from here, being educated here. And when I go to a new client, we go up in a tall skyscraper in an elevator, and that's usually Kone from Finland. Another thing, when we get to a meeting room, we talk about old Nokia phones, or because those phones were they were the best ones. They lasted 10 years. So 3110 is something everybody.
I mean, like, I remember. In my country, that when this Nokia 3310 comes out, you know, everyone is kind of like the design phone in my country at that time. And if you have that phone, like the phone that has touch, if you have that phone, you know, it means like, okay, you have something good.
Yeah.
So, I mean, Nokia is kind of like powerful.
It is powerful, and it's still powerful in a way. I never worked with Nokia, but still, it's something that connects. Nobody really knows Finland. We are so small. But Finnish engineering is famous.
Yeah.
So usually that is part of what connects me to other. But when I'm back in Finland, I'm suddenly not anymore so special, because here everybody are Finnish pretty rare. It's so different to try to sell myself here than out on the big world where it's big markets, more social people. Because what we describe as a software engineer is a little bit like normal Finnish guy.
But you know, when I met you, you know, I was like, wait, just a British guy. Because having a British accent. I mean, when you go out, do people really think you're Finnish? You're a Finnish person?
not always. I'm not a traditional Finnish person, I must say. I spent too much time abroad, pretty much 5 years altogether, and doing different software projects, and it's had an effect on me.
Yeah. But I also see that, I mean, despite your success story, I believe you have some challenges. I mean, that there are some moments in your life, I mean, doing what you do, that you come across some challenges, and you know, what actually gives you that strength to be to like say, okay, no, I'm not going to allow this to bring me down. I'm going to use this as my strength and move forward.
Oh, that's a tough one. I think, especially early on, like when I was new to freelancing and consulting, I made a mistake of not making clear contracts.
Okay.
And that caused I think it caused a big misunderstanding, and it's very unfortunate early on. It really brings you down that I'm like, because you thought something else than the other person thinks. So clear contract.
Okay.
That's very important. Even if you are really in a hurry, make clear contracts so everybody knows what is on the table, what are the stakes, and what needs to be built. And from there, I was pretty much saved by good relationships, so that I had a support network.
Okay.
And when I couldn't imagine where I'm gonna find my next project, my partner at the time told me that, hey, how about UK? And 2 weeks later, I moved to England, and the UK and I were working in London office, and it was easy. But I didn't realize it myself.
Yeah.
But my career really started after 5 years in work life, when I finally moved up road and got a bit broader perspective of things. Because it's really easy to be here where I'm comfortable in Finland and I know how things work.
Yeah, I do.
But I'm still walking like really with tunnel vision.
Yeah, yeah.
So now after several years
of that, you've acquired knowledge right now.
Exactly. It's been eye-opener.
I think that is so powerful, you know, dealing with, you have that capacity or that ability to deal with different personality or different companies from different areas.
Yes.
I think it's really, you know, that brings me to my quest, to my next move, you know. I mean, are you open to foreign market, like, you know, African market? You know, because I believe that there are companies in Africa who want to hire your service or who want to, you know, work with you. Are you open to that, to different cultures or something like that?
I would absolutely love to. Though, word of honor, I've traveled many continents, but I have never been on Southern America, neither in Africa.
Okay.
And I'd love to travel there. There is, of course, it's a massive area. Africa is several different lands.
Yeah, different countries.
Different countries, and that's why, of course, like they're so different in north than in south, in middle, and in the coast.
Yeah.
So, it would take several years to discover even like one part of it, but I'd love to.
Yeah. And what I've noticed is that Africa is part of the growing economy. That if anyone really want to impact their like kind of like have someone to consume their product instantly, then I believe that Africa is the right place, because I mean
there's a lot of articles about it, how Africa is developing. Yeah. There's new centralized, like new capitals are really emerging with
technology.
And with those emerging technology areas, I could really give impact. I could be mentor.
Yeah.
I could help organizing.
Yeah.
I could help with the coach and development and what is actually needed with the focus.
Okay.
I have worked in several different projects in different countries, so I've seen different ways of doing things.
Okay.
And I know that there is no one right way.
Yeah.
So it's more about how to find the right way for a certain company. And I have a mixed tool set that could be used for especially in the developing market.
Yeah. And I believe that there are African entrepreneurs or people who like consultant who watch my show, and I believe that they can, you know, relate with you with some of those companies who actually need this service, like mentorship, you know, like everything you provide. I believe that it's going to be great to develop the African economy and the people also.
Yeah, I'm also thinking that what I could help is I could help to establish an in-house software development team.
That's great.
I could help to train the early junior developers to be able to have the responsibility of the software. So once I'm ready, my goal is to make myself useless so that the people who I'm working with know what they need to do and how. And that's the ultimate goal.
Okay.
I think that's a good engineer thing.
Yeah, that's a good engineering thinking.
Yeah.
And at one point I see that if say your ideas, you know, can be put into a package, you know, like one package.
Oh my God, that's an ongoing project. It's not easy.
You know, like to put it in one package. Don't you think that you're gonna like go to someone's way like a bomb, boom, and you know, kind of like, okay, this is so much.
Yeah, I think there is something where I would need help to figure out what I could do in your area, what I could give to the businesses. I would need a couple of interviews maybe to with locals, and we would need to find common ground.
Yeah.
And then from there, I could like craft a package or a service that maybe helps a bit broader audience.
Yeah.
I don't know, what do you think?
Yeah, that's a good idea, because there are so many, I believe your strategy, I mean your approach, because it's not about what the people want. Mm-hmm. It's not about what what I'm not talking about politics, but what the government wants. But it's more about the people.
Yes.
Because if say you target the people, what the people really want, then I think that's more powerful than what the authorities think the people want.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I believe that is these companies who are doing the consultancy with other companies. I mean, we can set up. I mean, we can talk more about this and set up with these people and try to see how we can, you know, like how first of all meet those people.
Yes.
Try to understand what they really need and what are they, the project or what is really needed at this moment.
And maybe start with some kind of a pilot project.
Pilot project, yeah, something like
yes.
that.
And you'll have an initial pilot project, couple of interviews, which move into a pilot project, which move into maybe a bit more the big, larger market bridge.
Yeah, that's great. That's good.
It's weird how the idea just developed.
Yeah,
you have a good skill there.
Because of you, you know, when you meet someone who have a skill, I mean, it helps develop your own skill. I came here today. I saw you guys doing something, and I think my idea was stupid, but I was shocked that
brilliant. You brought so much on the table. We were already a little bit stuck, like looking at it. And when we talk with you for 5 minutes or 15, it's kind of formed a new angle. You want to do something. You kind of reached some kind of conclusion that he knows. My friend knows where to continue. I know what I need to provide for him. And once he's ready, we can move to the next phase.
Okay.
And it's and I think it's all about being open.
Open.
It's not like distraction. It's more like hey, you're here. Like, what's your input?
Yeah. Something like that. So I mean, there's someone watching you right now who think that you have done it all. The thing I've done it all. But I mean, this person might be going through kind of like the beginning stage, like they are maybe going through this kind of like, I mean, to start up a business or to engage in new ideas is always difficult at the beginning. So what can you say to that person who is like, listening to you right now to encourage them to like to keep doing what they do, no matter the challenges that they face in their lives?
Well, I think there is this couple of things you need to do. Like if you're not sure what you want to do something and move to the next one if it doesn't feel good. If you're a student, just graduated, go to work on a company. Go to find, or if that's not a good company, find another one. But work for a company and make mistakes whilst you work there. Make mistakes when you work for somebody else. Of course, you're gonna make enough mistakes when you start working for yourself. Once you work on your own business, make clear contracts. Be clear. Even though you wouldn't be exactly clear what you're selling, but when you get somebody interesting and you actually make sales, make sure that it's clear for both parties what is being sold. If the conditions change, you can always renegotiate. But most of all, trust yourself, trust your feeling of things. You don't always have time to think that these are the options because you will lose the opportunity. Go for it, trust your gut, and absolutely, like, be yourself. You don't have to be anybody else than yourself, because that's the most interesting part of any business, is the human connection also. Yeah.
If you are part of this show, or if you have been following this show from my previous episode, then you can bear with me that he has mentioned most of the things I say to you people. I mean, life is all about you focusing on the goal. Tell yourself that you can actually do this. I mean, even if you make challenges, it's fine because those challenges, it makes you become more stronger.
Exactly.
And it helps you to understand where you have to go.
A good thing. Yeah. Like what I just said, you are going to make mistakes.
Yeah.
That is for sure. It's just important you make those mistakes, otherwise you're going to repeat. If you don't dare, you won't grow.
Yeah.
You're going to make mistakes. Just get up. Learn from it, and it's as long as nobody died, it's all right.
It's okay. Yeah, I like that statement. As no one is dead, then it's fine.
Yes.
I mean, life goes on. You know, I mean, I'm impressed. In fact, I'm like excited to have you, or let me say, flabbergasted to have you.
Yeah, it's like, really nice. Like, yeah. Yes.
To have you in this show.
Like, have this conversation with a load. It just started rolling.
Yeah, that's good. I mean, do you have, like, I mean, something that you didn't mention that like, you really want to talk about?
Oh, what? It's been just been such a whirlpool of ideas. So, I don't know, just maybe thank you for the opportunity. And I look forward for maybe hearing from any ideas from other people. I'm happy to give any more feedback if something is unclear or pretty much that.
It was really nice having you in the show.
Thank you.
Viewers, you know, this is all we have for you today. And I believe that so far you have learned so much from Petola, and he is open-minded person, social, and willing to work with anyone. So if, say, you have an idea about any software or that you want to develop, or something that you think that might be important, or project that you think that might be might link his ideas to your ideas or to a company, then, I mean, I'm going to put the link of his Instagram and also the his LinkedIn, and if possible, his website, that you can go there and get a lot of information on what you think you can, you know, best approach when you want to get in touch with him. I mean, he's a nice guy, you know. I'm a nice guy also. So let's stick to each other, you know, as we grow this community together.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, like, feel free to contact me with any questions, any ideas, anything else. I'm sure that something great will rise from that.
Okay. On this note, have a nice day and bye-bye.
Bye-bye.